to live streaming. Oke, masuk. Masuk. We are still preparing our YouTube channel. So you're gonna be live on YouTube. There's three people outside in the waiting room. So I'd like to showing you the presentation that I just worked today.
Yeah, I look forward to it.
Yeah. Share screen. This is it. Can you see that?
Yep.
Yeah, the blank one with Learn From Home logo. This is just.
I can say that.
And we make it. No. We have. I think I will try the Zoom one. Zoom effect. So this is Konstantin Korsovidis Mas Kostas. So your photograph. In this session, I will introduce you. This is about you, tentang Konstantin Korsovidis. I will read out introduction. I just clip it from your website. As an Australian freelance photographer, Konstantin has a master's degree in documentary photography. So this one, I write it in Indonesia.
Okay.
Yeah, but I will say it in English.
Okay, no problem.
As an Australian freelance photographer, Konstantin has a master's degree in documentary photography from Sydney University, and a diploma of photography from TAFENSW.
That's right.
He has regularly exhibited his work both within Australia and internationally. He is an active participant in the Sydney music scene and a regular contributor to the Australian Free Press. He has worked on some Australia's largest festivals. And during his... So I should be playing the button. So during his overseas travels, he developed a strong interest in traditional theater, which led into a long-term project of documenting shadow puppetry throughout Southeast Asia. So this is my intro.
Okay.
And without further ado, I will hand it over to Mr. Kostas. But before I hand it over, I will show you Mr. Kostas' works. How's the transition? Is it a little smooth than before?
It's better than before.
Better than all. Good.
But no music? Mas Rizal,
yes.
Is this the music? No.
Yeah. You're not hearing the music? No? Oh, wait. Okay, wait. It should be...
Buka aja dulu filenya, nanti share screen langsung dia ketemu yang share screen langsung. Aktif, yang share yang aktif itu.
Ini harusnya Mas Kostas sudah langsung dengar musik. Tapi musiknya enggak kedengeran. Sampean krungu musik ya, Mas Rizky? Halo, Mas Rizky? Mas Rizky? Mas Rizky?
Udah.
Mas Rizky?
Kita dapat dari Mas Rizal. Belum lagi ngobrol-ngobrol sama Korsofotis. Lagi ngobrol.
Oh.
Buka tadi.
He's still talking with Faisal in WhatsApp.
Yeah.
Mas Rizky.
Belum.
Oi.
Bentar. Tak kirim ya. Okay. Yo.
Mas.
Ya.
Sampean aku nyetel video mau krungu musiknya enggak?
Enggak.
Oh, oke. Okay. Berarti aku harus set up. Set up the music. Do I do that? Stop share dulu. Oke. Video setting, share screen. Test. Share screen, maximize silent system notification, sharing desktop. Oh, okay, back. So, kita tes lagi, sekali lagi, share screen. Can you see my?
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
Yep.
Okay, can you hear the sound?
There's no sound.
There's no sound at all?
Nope.
Oh.
Just the photos.
Just the photos.
Check sound.
Check sound. Check, check, check.
Check. Hello, Gustas.
Hello. How are you?
Fine, Mas.
Mas Faisal, kelihatan presentasi yang saya mainin ini.
Aman, kelihatan.
Live musiknya interior. Kedengeran nggak?
Ora.
Oh, betul, Mas.
Betul, Mas. Saya tak undang-undang orang di
okay, siap.
Facebook. Biar
siap, siap.
Info. Mas Nanang, sudah masuk? Aman, Mas Nanang?
Aman, Mas.
Mas Kostas nggak jadi pakai batik?
No batik tonight, man.
Maybe I should wear my hat too, like Mas Kostas.
That's it?
Boleh pakai topi nggak, Mas Rizal?
Kenapa?
Boleh pakai topi?
Boleh gak? Aja, boleh aja. Bebas.
Bersama Mas Kostas.
Tas. Halo, Mas Nanang.
Mas Kostas, suaranya kecil.
Nice to meet you again. Kangen. Nice.
Mas, how are you?
I'm fine, fine.
Halo, Mas Nanang.
Mas Rizal.
Ini saya lagi testing share screen-nya.
Iya. Iya, Mas. Aman.
Mas Rizky udah?
Ada itu, Mas Rizky. Sebentar.
Renan diganjel ya laptopnya, tinggian gini.
Advance sharing also.
Ini belum direcord kan?
Sudah masuk YouTube, Mas. Sudah masuk.
Aduh.
Tapi kan orang nggak tahu. Santai aja. Ini lagi nyoba, lagi nyoba ini. Saya bikin.
Ini keren.
Ah, ini modelnya. Keluar nih ya, keluar ya. Presentasinya.
Aman. Musiknya
aman. Ada. Sebentar, belum masuk video. Ini masuk nggak musiknya?
Nggak ada.
Nggak ada ya?
Nggak ada.
Masuk.
Enggak.
Stop share dulu ya. Soalnya yang biasa operating kan Mas Rizmi biasanya. Jadi ini saya baru utak-utik hari ini.
Okay. Oh, recording-nya jadi start di situ, Mas.
Enggak apa-apa, biar aja. Nah, ini kan udah masuk ya.
Masuk, baik kok.
Masuk, oke. Masuk, fotonya Kostas. Tentang Konstantin. Oke, masuk. Masuk.
Kosek balu, kulitik, kulit.
Masuk, musiknya.
Masuk, baik kok. Masuk,
beli Yudhani.
Apa yang banget?
Tri.
Jadi ini saya presentasinya nggak pakai PowerPoint, Mas. Saya pakai HTML.
Bisa aneh. Pojok mantang.
Lebih enteng. Cuman ya ngoding gitu loh.
Lorok. Yo nek ngedok. Ku nek
ngelek. It's very loud.
Very loud. Too loud.
Bagus.
Enggak. Bagus. Bagus.
Di
sama. Too loud. Oke, okay, too loud.
Itulah.
No, 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 no. Show control.
Pun akan sakup akan larap lagi. Kalasan bahayumu yang kadamu.
Like this? It's better. Okay. It means, yeah, 15%. Okay. Sorry Mas Nanang, kita awur anu nih Mas. Lagune tak awur aku main comot golek tangane. Tak tumpuk-tumpuki jadi antara gamelan sampai dalang ngomong wis mbok tak tumpuk ae.
Pak mantep itu.
Ya Pak mantep ya.
Depan tadi.
Oh. Gak sing menarik kan ojo jagane ndoke blorok iku lho.
Ini apa itu? Ojo jagake.
Ndoke blorok.
Ndoke.
Ndoke blorok.
Telurnya.
Mas, telurnya ayam blorok.
Ya jangan berharap yang memang nggak bisa diharapkan.
Nah, don't take it for granted. Ojo njagake ndoke blorok.
Can you repeat that? Mas Kostas, ojo njagake ndoke blorok.
Yeah,
that's going to be... I'm probably going to need a couple of drinks before that. So I think already 5 people entering the waiting room. So I think you have to fast forward this one.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And this is your project outline. Will be previous like this. And you're talking,
okay.
And when you're talking about research, I will set it to the research Australia Indonesia, and this is your gallery show slideshow. So this one is not autoplay; it's manually play. So you can, You just say next.
Okay.
It's about 20 image.
25, I think.
20 image. Ah, project objective. Why this project? Why wayang? So the Indonesian is the big one, the bold one, Tujuan project is project objective.
Okay, so when I go from one slide to the other, should I tell you to go into the next thing or what should
for
I
the
do?
For the slide, it's okay. You can say next.
But what
you can
about
say next.
What about when I'm talking about the project and you want to go into the next?
I think I should hear you. I should hear you. So I should follow you.
I was project objectives or the next.
Yeah. Thing. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Wayang. The future for wayang. So this is the Indonesian.
Mas Faisal bisa coba share screen, Mas
Rizal. Oh iya dong, belum pernah.
Sebentar. This is advice for photographer, okay. And this is the epilogue in your photos, and your website and Instagram.
Okay.
Question and answer forum tanya jawab. So terima kasih. That's all.
Turn one.
Okay.
Okay, so I will stop share and Mas Faisal, you can turn share your screen.
Never done it before. Share screen. Host disable participant shares.
Ah, sudah. Yeah. share screen. Sebentar, sebentar, sebentar. Host disable.
Oh, yang ini Mas, Mas Reski ya? Aku kudu buka disini ya, Mas Rizal?
Ya.
File-nya?
Mm-mm.
Oh, tak buka.
Sebaiknya dibuka dulu, disiapin di halaman yang pertama. Nah, kemudian pada saat ini kan Windows-nya banyak tuh. Siap. Jadi tinggal pilih nanti.
Mas Rizal.
Yuk.
Mas Faisal di co-host dulu.
Oh iya sih, Mas Faisal kurang di co-host. Itu kenapa nggak bisa share screen?
Masuk.
Anang juga.
Meko-host. Konstantin juga.
Konstantin, Meko-host.
Konstantin, I have to make you co-host. Okay, so you can control. Mas Nanang juga co-host. Ah, wis, iso Mas. Coba Mas.
Share screen, pencet. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, aku milih.
Milih Windows yang ada share screen-nya.
Iya.
Yeah. Did I do something from my end?
Ngilangin yang kanan ini gimana ya?
Oh, ngilangin ininya?
Iya. Yeah. Gak usah kali ya?
Oh, kanannya
ini. Free 7 day trial di sini, di sini.
Full screen aja bisa nggak?
Caranya?
Full screen kalau PDF. Wah, Windows ini Mas Rizky. Mas Rizky, Windows. Komputer wedus sih. Mas Rizky.
Kalau PDF ini.
PDF, cukup kali gini ya?
Pakai ini ya.
PDF. Mendingan PPT apa PDF?
Browsernya pakai itu.
Mas Rizky kecil banget suaranya.
Halo.
Suaramu kurang gede, Mas.
Halo, gini.
Ya, oke, okay. good, sip.
Ah. Ya gitu aja sih, Mas.
Ini kalau enggak
cukup ya? Kalau bagian yang kanan ada gambar-gambar orang gitu.
Ada tombol halaman terus panahnya.
Sebentar.
Itu kan ada tangan minus plus 73%. Terus nah, sebelahnya yang biru itu.
Yang panah-panah. View
yang ini.
Ada
tangan foto-foto kita.
Oh, ada gambar tangan. Terus minus. Yang atas. Mana? Icon, ini. Iconnya. Sebelahnya. Terus. Lagi. Kiri. Terus.
Lagi.
Terus.
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 Terus. Terus. Terus.
Dua lagi. Nah itu. Ya, coba. Klik.
Wartul.
Klik kanan dulu. Apa itu?
Yang ini ya.
Klik. Ya sebelahnya.
Ini ya.
Iya.
Klik kanan. Yang ini.
Itu loh.
Ah, itu
fit. Fit one full page.
Udah dicentang tapi one full page itu.
Gua diam aja deh.
Enggak pas, Mas. Coba lagi.
Tuh. Fit one full page.
Oh iya, udah kecentang ya.
Bacaan gitu, Bang. Wedus.
Coba kalau yang 100, oh kalau 100% dia malah over ini ya, nge-zoom ya. Kalau klik yang itu Mas, icon yang
ya.
Sebelahnya yang itu, sebelahnya yang kotak-kotak itu.
Aku ulang dulu, open dia terus.
Atau kalau enggak coba sih, Control F bisa enggak dia? Biasanya sih.
Di mau ya.
Control F coba. Biasanya bisa itu.
Sebentar. Yang ini ya, PDF kan?
Iya. Belum keluar, Mas.
Dah?
Belum keluar.
Oke. Keluar enggak?
Belum.
Share dokumen, Mas.
Hah? Oh iya.
Share dokumen bawahnya yang hijau ditekan dulu.
Tadi aku kehilangan Zoom Call Meeting.
Mas Rizky nanti buka duluan ya.
Oke.
Okay. Mas Rizky buka duluan.
Share screen ya.
Ya. Yeah.
So you are the next.
Waduh. Control F.
Control F, iso.
Control F.
Gak gelem ya.
Gak mau.
Gak apa-apa lah mas.
Ya wis gak apa-apa.
Gila enak free 7 day trial di sini-sini. Oh, I know. Haha.
Nah itu bisa. Aja.
Wis ta iki? 751 loh.
Orangnya berapa?
Di admit ya.
Orangnya udah berapa orang itu? Udah 13 partisipan.
Nah, karena masuk keluar.
Iya, soalnya dipikir nggak ada acara. Kan kita 7.30 toh. Udah telat 20 menit. Admit all aja ya, langsung ya.
Iya.
Tung.
Soalnya biasanya jam 8:30.
Oh, biasanya 8:30 ya, yang normal ya?
Baru ramenya.
Normalnya bukanya 8:30. Karena 9. Ini connect sama jam Sydney, jadi agak dimajukan.
Selamat malam, Pak Kim San.
Halo, malam-malam.
Ini malam ini Mas Dodi nggak bisa aktif karena ada halangan.
Oh, makanya kok dengarin ora ketok suarane.
Lah ya kuwi.
Ora kena kopi ora.
Selamat malam, Pak Kim.
Halo.
Faisal di sini.
Iya. Malam juga.
Halo Om Kim.
Yuk.
Malam. Rizky nih.
Selamat malam.
Malam.
Yang pakai Galaxy A30 siapa ya?
Halo Om Jo. Ada Om Jo juga tuh.
Om Jo itu siapa? Johannes Surbakti.
Johannes Surbakti.
Wah. Itu bendahara APFI Karawang. Aku harus nge-share terus ini ya? Masih ya?
Iya,
stop. Yeah, dulu, stop share dulu.
Stop share, oke.
Okay. Kan belum mulai ya? Masih bisa rokokan ya?
Ya, santai.
Kantor ini.
Ini keluar frame terus, so. Begitu sadar, aduh ketangkap tadi.
Nggak, harusnya kalau mau rokokan ya gini dulu. Nah.
Karena ra oleh rokokan ya, ditonton bocah.
Nanti kan udah mulai mati kok.
Orang apa mas. Khasnya kan.
Rokokan kok ya nggak bosan-bosan toh mas.
Ya.
Lakuwi loh pak.
Dinasehati Pak Kim.
Rokokan nggak bosan-bosan, itu duit dibakari terus si Pita.
Ora dibakar Pak Kim, dipanggang.
Oh, dipanggang ta. Sepurane aku nek ngomong to the point soal.
Mas Kostas ora ngerti ya, gocekane.
Mas Kostas smiley.
Because you don't know what we're talking about.
I don't understand, sure.
No. Oh, ini yang kayak Australia.
Iya. Yeah.
So,
Godong Linjo.
This now we have 16 participants.
Okay.
This is loyal participants actually. Every single LFH even there will be here.
Have you shared to this Australian photographer, Mas Kostas? The poster. Have you shared to Australian photographer?
Have you shared to your friend, Mas Kostas?
Yeah, I did.
Ah, good.
The link, eh?
Yeah, I sent the link to some photographers and also Puppetry Association.
Ah, oh, I see. International Puppetry.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Oh.
It's called the UNIMA.
Oh, I see.
It's a French organization that has offices all over the world.
Oh. Wah, ini di-share internasional, Pak. Jadi di-share asosiasi dalang internasional.
Sekedap saya mengundang Senawangi Rumien.
UNIMA Nasional Universal Institute of Marionette.
Oh, I see.
UNIMA.
UNIMA.
Yes. Ya, Australia-nya di mana? Di Melbourne atau di Sydney? Where you stay in Australia?
I stay in Sydney.
Sydney. Oh.
Today Begadang. Is a bit...
Begadang ini Pak Kim, beliaunya ini. Begadang beliaunya ini.
Oh iya, ya. Di sana 4 jam lebih cepat.
Iya. So. Already
midnight.
Midnight.
Now it's nearly midnight, yes.
Ya. Temanku ada yang di sana soalnya.
I hope you know I give up my sleep for this, yeah?
Have you got your coffee?
No, if I drink coffee now, I cannot sleep again, yeah?
Eat.
Tea.
Do you miss nasi goreng, Mas Kostas?
No, I can have this every day here, yeah? In Australia, yeah?
How many times you come to Indonesia?
Too many.
Too many.
I come every year for the last 7 years.
Oh, 7 years.
And I come maybe sometimes 2 times, 3 times.
Oh. When you come to Indonesia, you stay here or 3 months or 1 year in here?
I stay a long time. Usually 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. Oh. Like,
it means you can say Indonesian.
I can say some things, yeah. Only bad things.
Only the dirty.
No problem. You can say Indonesian a little bit. No problem.
I don't teach you, yeah.
I think maybe he's not ready for bad words.
Bad words, yeah.
Mungkin kita bisa dengar lagunya Mas Nanang. Om Rizal, Mas Nanang ini lagu-lagu tentang wayangnya keren-keren.
Oh ya? Wah, ya, boleh
sudah
dong.
Sudah menelurkan satu album, Kinanti.
Waduh.
Larung. Larut ya? Sorry, maaf Mas.
Iya.
Wah, tahu gitu tak tampilin ya tadi ya di jadi background-nya.
Coba sekarang aja.
Itu Nanang kan agak gitar itu. Coba lu main aja sebentar.
Oh, ya. Iya, Mas. Terima kasih waktu, Mas.
Agak gitar kok. Mumpung mataku masih ketok. Ayo Nanang.
Performance.
Asik. Ini baru asik ini.
Kita ini ya. Apa? Mute semua.
Ya.
Ya.
Wayang wewayangan. Wajah-wajah. Kisah-kisah dipahatkan di batu-batu diukirkan di kayu-kayu wajahku, wajahmu. Rupa-rupa berjuta cerita cerminan hidup.
Pun matur nuwun asik.
Yang dari Kinanti Larut, Mas.
Ya.
Lagi dong.
Nanang ku ngomain di ta Nanang?
Cipayung, dekat Taman Mini.
Oh, Cipayung toh.
Belakang Taman Mini.
Ya, ya, ya.
Oh, berarti yang Jawa Mas Faisal maunya.
Iya dong. Yang dari Kinanti Larut.
Sepining son tutu subunging wengi nanging sepah sepo sepining ati tatu kang kinarit urip tukara tembung kang sineret namboro rumpoko lumengko latimu kang cuwo pinalang samudro impen setiamu kang cu
tampon.
Very nice.
Oh, keren. Amazing.
Sudah ada 20 partisipan.
Hah? 5 menit mana?
5 menit lagi.
Ya, 5 menit mana lah tengah waktu 5 menit. Tak pikir tengah walu mau tak.
Pak Kim dalamnya di mana?
Aku tak.
Ya.
Di Denpasar.
Oh, di Bali.
Iya.
Wih, keren.
Keren piye, Mas? Pokoke wae sumpek.
Mendino vacation eh.
Aliyah.
If you live Sawa in Bali, so every day you do the vacation, Mas Kostas. Mr. Kim live in Bali, Mas Kostas.
Mr. Kim Bali is very nice, but too many tourists.
Yeah.
Yeah. But if I stay here, I'm very boring. Go to apa tourist location. Bosan malahan itu.
Nah, Balinese people are very nice, but
yeah,
too many foreigners.
I know.
Yeah,
it's good. It's good for Bali, but it's bad for me.
Balinese people same with Japanese people lah, like this. Same.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sounds good.
I want to get away from Australian people. Yeah.
Oh.
Not to meet more Australian people. That's okay. It's okay. It's the same problem everywhere, yeah, with tourism.
Yeah.
Especially if the country is dependent on money from tourists. Yeah, it can be difficult.
Mass tourism is very bad.
Of course, of course. Yeah, it's bad for nature, bad for everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just have to look at, you know, Jogja, have to look at Bali.
Yeah.
Or Phuket, it's the same thing.
Yeah. Same.
It's the local people have a fatigue, from tourism, yeah?
Yeah.
They are tired, but also they need the tourists too, yeah?
They are tired, but the money make him happy.
Sure, sure, but but sometimes it's just nice to have peace and quiet, yeah?
Yeah.
Or to not see so much development or so much destruction, yeah?
Yeah.
So it must be a balance of both money and sustainability.
Bu Bonis.
But many people from Indonesia come to Australia now, yeah?
Yeah.
I know.
Many.
Go to study to Australia.
Study or make business or have family or do something different, check, yeah?
Satu,
sure.
Satu.
Near where I stay, I have many Indonesian people, many restaurants, so I can have Indonesian food every day.
Betul,
for sure. Ketoprak.
Gadu.
Yeah, many things.
Sugeng dalu, Bu Bonis.
Oh, yes. Sugeng dalu. Matur sembah nuwun, Pak Dodi. Mas Dodi, maaf.
Rizal nih, Bu.
Rizal.
Aku Mas Rizal, Bu.
Oh, yes, Mas Rizal.
Pak Dodi lagi berhalangan.
Oh, yes. Salam sehat. Dangu, yeah. Boten pinaku. Mugi tansah pinaringan karaharjan.
Amin.
Halo Bu Bonis.
Mas Rizal.
Yeah.
Jangan lupa besok izin kaldera ya.
Oh siap.
Diumumkan.
Siap.
Wes dimulai ae kok
masak. Ayo wes.
Monggo sekali.
Mas Rizal, Pak Joni yuk. Di co-host.
Oke, starting.
Pak Joni make co-host. Oke.
Oke, thank you.
Ini mau Pak Joni yang buka ya? Atau Mas Rizky?
Enggak apa-apa.
Mas Zainal, Mas Rizal aja.
Enggak, Mas Rizky dong.
Oh iya, yes. Aku posisi saya ini lagi.
Oke.
Oke, silakan Mas Rizky.
Yuk. Oke. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat malam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Selamat malam, Mas Kostas, Mas Nana.
Selamat malam.
Selamat malam.
Mas Faisal, saya sapa-sapa dulu teman-teman. Di sini ada 19 partisipan. Tadi ada 20, mungkin berkurang satu lagi tadi. Ada teman-teman saya juga, tadi ada Bang Jo yang di Karawang. Malam ini edisi kita agak berbeda karena kita mengangkat tema wayang tradisional banget, dan kita mengetengahkan seorang fotografer dari Sydney, Mas Kostas. Nama lengkapnya Kostas, agak susah spellingnya. Konstantin Kors.
Korsovitis.
Looks like Greece name, yeah.
Yeah, it's from Greece.
Oh, I think so.
From Yunani.
Yeah, Yunani. Okay. Untuk yang pertama, mungkin kita akan membahas tentang wayang dari sisi sudut pandang seorang Mas Faisal Ahmad, yaitu seorang fotografer stage yang
Indonesia
ya, yang khususnya banyak memotret hal-hal peristiwa-peristiwa event-event tradisional. Ini cukup berpengalaman juga, akan saya bacakan nanti CV-nya. Kemudian juga ada Mas Nanang, Ki Dalang Nanang ya, Nanang HP. Ya. Nanti bisa memberikan beberapa wacana-wacananya tentang perwayangan. Oke, sekarang saya akan bacakan dulu siapa sih Mas Faisal ini, Faisal Ahmad ya. Faisal Ahmad. Oke, di sini Faisal Ahmad, seorang sebetulnya secara akademisi seorang sarjana akuntansi ya, ekonomi akuntansi dari Unpas. Pengalamannya banyak sekali, mungkin kalau dibacakan ini akan panjang sekali, nggak akan habis nih. Dari Official Stage Performing Arts Photographer, pentas kelompok seni budaya, yaitu Patnetswara, Opera Jawa, Ki Mantep, Sudarsono, Dedi Lutan Dance Company, Ratu Sima, Artina Production, Swargaloka, sampai dengan, wah banyak sekali nih. Kemudian pengalaman fotografinya juga banyak. Beliau ini sebagai official photographer for Damian Aditya. Ya, Damian Aditya ini ilusionis ya, ilusionis. Wah, berarti tahu banyak tentang rahasia-rahasia sulapnya Kang Damian ini. Nanti bisa sharing, Mas, bocorin dikit lah. Kemudian official presidential photographer for Venezuela, KTT Asia Afrika tahun 2014. Kemudian ada official stage photographer DARR, Erwin Gutawa and Gutawa Project. Sekarang lagi aktif di sebagai ketua Asosiasi Profesi Fotografi Indonesia, Pengcap Karawang. Nah, kebetulan dulu saya juga sempat tinggal di Karawang hampir 4 tahun, tapi saya belum ketemu. Begitu saya keluar dari Karawang, Mas Faisal ke sana. Dan ada beberapa pengalaman sebagai dewan juri lomba foto, kemudian ketua acara Canon Bekasi Foto Marathon, ada founder of FAP Commercial Photography, wah banyak banget lah. Dan ada exhibition foto juga, solo exhibition foto, Kalingga, sampai dengan solo photo exhibition jejak repertoire di LDC, Padepokan Tari di LDC di Jakarta. Wah, banyaklah pokoknya nih. Oke, nggak usah panjang lebar, nanti terlalu lebar juga offside nanti. Saya serahkan langsung ke Mas Faisal ya. Monggo Mas Faisal, silakan.
Saya izin share screen ya, Mas.
Siap.
Ya, silakan.
Oke. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam sejahtera untuk kita semua. Terima kasih kepada LFA. Kali ini saya diundang oleh LFA untuk yang kedua kali. Yang pertama kemarin membahas tentang pendokumentasian kesenian tradisi, yang kedua kali ini membahas tentang wayang kulit, pemotretan wayang kulit. Yang saya hormati juga para senior fotografer, guru-guru saya, Mas Rizal, Mas Reski sebagai moderator dan panitia dari LFA. Dan saya di LFA ini kemarin hasil dari ngobrol-ngobrol dengan Mas Dodi, Mas Dodi tentang wayang kulit, pemotretan wayang kulit. Terus saya infokan ke Mas Dodi bahwa saya punya teman di Australia yang juga memotret wayang kulit. Mas Kostas, akhirnya saya hubungi Mas Kostas dan beliau bersedia untuk join bersama kita malam ini. Lalu juga kakak saya, ini Mas Nanang HP, dalang yang lagi hit saat ini, terutama di kalangan anak-anak muda. Beliau juga merupakan seorang akademisi dari ISI Solo, lulusan jurusan pedalangan. Semoga kolaborasi dari kami bertiga malam ini bisa membuka wawasan dari teman-teman fotografer untuk melakukan pemotretan di panggung-panggung wayang kulit yang tersebar di seluruh Indonesia. Saya dan Mr. Kostas have something in common. First, we don't come from wayang kulit family. Saya dan Mas Kostas tidak ada background keluarga atau kuliah atau hal lain yang terkait wayang kulit. Benar-benar kita melakukan fotografi ini karena rentaknya kami, ya, rasa keinginan kami untuk melakukan pemotretan di wayang kulit. And the second, we both like Ramones music. Yeah. Mas Kostas, ya. Okay.
Of course.
Nah, ini kita mulai di slide kedua, yaitu tantangan dalam pemotretan wayang kulit. Sebelumnya, yang ingin saya sampaikan adalah tentang eksplorasi angle saya di wayang kulit, pentas wayang kulit. Jadi, angle exploration in wayang kulit stage photography. Jadi, dalam melakukan eksplorasi angle tersebut, Mas Nanang juga pernah bertanya kepada saya di eventnya Mas Nanang tentang wayang, fotografi wayang. Di situ kita juga sempat membahas ini, yaitu tantangan dalam melakukan fotografi di wayang kulit itu, layar wayang kulit itu sendiri merupakan layar dua dimensi. Jadi layar dua dimensi itu cenderung flat dan sempit. Gitu. Jadi bagaimana tugas seorang fotografer di situ, apa yang dilakukan seorang fotografer di situ adalah menerjemahkan hal-hal apa saja yang tidak bisa dilihat oleh penonton. Jadi penonton itu kan jaraknya sama panggung wayang itu lumayan jauh, sekitar bisa sampai 5-10 meter. Nah, mereka kan tidak melihat apa-apa saja yang terjadi di atas panggung wayang kulit. Nah, dengan fotografi dan angle exploring saya itu, saya berusaha untuk menerjemahkan secara visual hal-hal yang tidak dilihat oleh para penonton lain. Dan itu memerlukan suatu challenge juga dalam melakukan eksplorasi angle tersebut, yaitu di wayang kulit itu kita tidak bisa sembarangan memotret juga. Maksudnya dalam hal kaidah tata kramanya. Kalau untuk panggung wayang kulit sendiri itu sangat bebas. Tapi yang saya sayangkan di beberapa sebagian besar atau beberapa pertunjukan wayang kulit yang saya datangi untuk melakukan pemotretan di situ, yang motret ya cuman saya. Kenapa? Nah, ini yang menjadi pertanyaan dan buat teman-teman se-Indonesia. Lalu di sini dalam pemotretan tersebut ada tata krama, misalnya hal-hal yang terkait dengan pertunjukannya sendiri. Ini kan pertunjukan, termasuk pertunjukan yang sakral, di mana di situ ada do and don't-nya, seperti tata krama terhadap dalang, misalnya kita di panggung itu tidak boleh berdiri ngungkuli dalang, misalnya gitu. Nah, mungkin nanti bisa dijelaskan lebih lanjut oleh Mas Nanang. Tapi hal-hal seperti itu harus kita patuhi dalam pemotretan yang pertunjukan yang berbau tradisi seperti wayang kulit. Lalu yang ketiga tantangannya adalah di pencahayaan. Layar wayang kulit itu disinari oleh blencong. Blencong itu kalau dulu dari api, tapi sekarang sudah dengan lampu, ya, Mas Anang. Lampunya apa ya, Mas Anang, namanya, ya? Apa bulb gitu, ya?
Kalau sekarang elektrik, biasanya pakai halogen.
Halogen, ya, Mas, ya?
Halogen, ya.
Ya, jadi itu kan agak flat, ya, cahayanya jadi flat gitu loh. Nah, bagaimana kita membuat foto-foto yang bisa menarik dalam kondisi seperti itu? Tentunya kita saya sendiri perlu melakukan eksplorasi angle ini. Jadi dengan pencahayaan dari blencong itu, yang terlihat itu lebih 85% itu cahaya ke layar, tidak ke dalang. kalau kita mau memotret untuk mau bisa memperlihatkan wajah dalangnya itu kadang-kadang di layarnya overexpose gitu. Nah, bagaimana cara kita untuk pintar-pintar mengatur exposure supaya bisa pas, dua-duanya bisa pas gitu. Dalangnya juga terlihat, wayang-wayangnya yang indah-indah itu juga bisa terlihat. Nah, mungkin teman-teman bisa melakukan juga pemotretan wayang kulit dan merasakan sendiri mungkin nanti ya di situ. Lalu berikutnya tantangannya adalah di penonton atau pengisi acara di panggung. Kalau penonton itu begitu nanti mulai wayangnya itu kan wayang kulit hiburan rakyat. Jadi nanti kalau pas udah agak malam itu rame banget gitu. Panggungnya rame sekali, dempet-dempetan itu. Dan yang tadi penonton-penonton yang berjarak duduknya tadi di depannya itu sudah banyak orang-orang gelar tikar, biasanya duduk-duduk di situ. Sehingga untuk perpindahan dari angle to angle itu memerlukan harus kehati-hatian dan menjaga sopan santun juga terhadap penonton-penonton yang ada di situ. Kadang-kadang kita nggak bisa sambil ngendong tas kamera yang baik berbentuk ransel ataupun yang sling bag karena di situ kan sempit, kita mau menerobos masuk supaya dapat gambar. Itu beberapa tantangan dalam pemotretan wayang kulit yang saya alami selama ini. Lalu kita masuk ke slide berikutnya, yaitu udah mulai cerita tentang foto. Di sini saya memotret Ki Mantep Sudarsono. Yang sebelah kiri ini saya potret pada jam 3:30 pagi, pada saat beliau sudah selesai melakukan pertunjukan. Nah, ini pose khasnya beliau itu ini, karena beliau ini terkenal pernah menjadi bintang iklan dari satu produk obat batuk, bapak obat apa ya waktu itu. Nah, dikenal sampai saat ini orang Pak Mantep Oye. Nah, ini saya minta beliau, Pak Oye, Pak. Nah, beliau mau post. Nah, hal-hal seperti ini memerlukan kesabaran dari fotografer. Karena kalau kita minta beliau untuk post di awal pertunjukan, beliau masih belum tenang. Nah, kecuali kalau seperti pertunjukan sudah berakhir, terus kita minta beliau post atau kita minta beliau untuk bisa menyesuaikan dengan apa yang kita kehendaki, itu beliau udah relax, udah santai gitu. Nah, itu harus tahan ngantuk, tapi selesainya sekitar jam 4, kadang-kadang 3:30 baru selesai. Nah, ini di kanan waktu saya sama beliau di kondangan. Saya lanjutkan. Nah, ini yang saya ceritakan tadi, bagaimana dalam pemotretan wayang kulit itu kita tidak bisa cuman memotret dalangnya saja atau wayangnya saja. Pak Purbo Asmoro pernah cerita juga ke saya yang bahwa beliau itu tertarik apabila dalam pemotretan wayang kulit itu bisa kelihatan wayangnya sama bisa kelihatan dalangnya. Nah, mungkin ini yang saya explore, angle seperti ini, di mana di gunungan ini juga tatahannya itu terlihat, yang sebelah kiri, foto sebelah kiri, tatahannya terlihat di situ. Kita bayangkan bagaimana si pembuat wayang ini, gunungan ini, dalam memproduksi sebuah gunungan memerlukan keahlian khusus dan kesabaran. Mungkin ini dipahat dari kulit disamak terus dipahat sehingga sebelah kiri ini bisa menghasilkan detail seperti itu. Nah, ini kalau kita potret dari bayangannya itu kelihatan. Nah, ini di sebelah kanan yang saya cerita tadi kendalanya ada di pencahayaan dari belencong. Belencong ini sangat cahayanya sangat terang dan menyorot ke layar langsung. Nah, ini bagaimana kita pintar-pintar menyiasati cahaya belencong ini sendiri. Nah, lalu berikutnya, kalau yang kiri ini khasnya Pak Mantep, biasanya beliau itu walaupun sudah sepuh, cuman masih kuat untuk salto wayang. Jadi wayang itu dilempar dan ditahan pakai wayang yang satu lagi dengan tangan beliau yang satu lagi. Nah, ini kalau di kanan, ini permainan shadow-nya Pak Mantep ini. Ini yang kanan wayangnya apa ya, Mas Nenang ya?
Iya, Mas. Apa?
Yang kanan wayangnya apa ini, Mas?
Kecil sekali, kurang.
Kecil, nggak kelihatan. Nah, ini beliau suka bermain shadow ini, ngambil dari cahaya blencong yang sebelah kanan atas itu. Kita kalau harus siap-siap terus, kalau fotografer harus nunggu dengan sabar, siap, tenang, nanti bagaimana permainan shadow dari sang dalang itu sendiri bisa kita capture. Lalu berikutnya, nah ini dalang senior, Nisri Sulansi Panjang Mas. Beliau ini sudah dalang sepuh, dalang ruat. Nah, ini yang sebelah kiri, ini wayang-wayang yang dimainkan beliau. Ini wayang revolusi. Ini ada di museum wayang di Kota Tua. Kalau beliau mau pentas wayang revolusi, wayang-wayang ini nanti dikeluarkan. Kalau di kanan yang sedang beliau mainkan ini, kalau nggak salah wayang kancil. Beliau juga dalang wayang kancil. Nah, ini termasuk ini seperti ibu saya sekarang ya, gara-gara pemotretan ini beliau sangat dekat sekarang, baik dengan saya. Nah, lalu ini pemotretan Ki Anom Suroto. Nah, ini khasnya beliau ini wayangnya itu suka diputar di atas kepala beliau, dan ini endingnya ini. Jadi sedang memainkan wayang itu tiba-tiba diputar gitu, diputar, dan endingnya di sini, baru dimainkan lagi di panggung. Nah, ini pemotretan Ki Purbo Asmoro. Ki Purbo Asmoro juga, beliau juga senang bermain dengan ini ya, warna gitu ya, di wayang-wayangnya beliau itu sangat suka sekali. Beliau ini dalang di dosen di ISI Surakarta. Lalu berikutnya, ini saya waktu memotret Ki Entus Susmono almarhum, dulu Bupati Tegal. Nah, ini ciri khasnya dalang-dalang ini kalau lagi sedang pentas itu suka ngerokok gitu. Nah, saya di sini nunggu rokoknya nih kapan gitu, disembur asapnya, karena yang seperti ini nih saya seneng aja gitu, seperti dry ice ya. Padahal itu asap dari rokoknya beli almarhum ini. Nah, beliau meninggalnya tahun berapa ya, Mas Endang ya?
Dua tahun lalu ya.
Dua tahun yang lalu, Mas ya. Beliau sudah situ, sudah meninggal. Nah, ini beliau lagi benerin wayang. Ini belakangnya beliau terlihat itu ada bayangannya. Sedang ini waktu pementasan tiga dalang. Nah, ini momen yang sangat langka di mana para maestro dalang Indonesia, para senior dalang Indonesia berada di dalam satu panggung bersamaan. Di paling kiri almarhum Ki Entus Susmono, yang tengah Ki Mantep Sudarsono, yang paling kanan Ki Purbo Asmoro. Ini dalang-dalang top, maestro-maestronya pedalangan dalam satu pentas memainkan wayang bersama. Nah, lalu ini narasumber kita malam ini, Mas Nanang HP. Ini saya memotret beliau waktu sedang pentas di Bekasi waktu itu. Nah, yang dari depan ini cahaya dari blencong, yang belakang cahaya dari lampu neon panggung. Biasanya panggung wayang itu lampunya neon dan di depannya itu sorotan blencong. Beliau juga lagi habis ngerokok ini ya, Mas Nenang. Nah, ini yang saya ceritakan tadi, bagaimana saya sebagai fotografer ingin menerjemahkan secara visual kepada para penonton wayang, di mana para penonton wayang ini tidak bisa dari tempat duduknya itu melihat hal-hal seperti ini. Ini seperti ini kita lihat di bawah ini, Mas Nenang, di kakinya ini ada keprak, terus cempolonya Mas Nenang nggak kelihatan ya? Jadi terus di kiri kita lihat juga ada kotak wayang. Kotak wayang itu berisi wayang-wayang yang akan di mainkan pada malam tersebut. Dan di belakang Mas Nanang itu ada asisten dalangnya, peniti ya Mas ya namanya?
Ya, peniti atau penyimping. Ya.
Peniti atau penyimping, asisten dalang ini nanti bertugas untuk merapikan wayang-wayang yang kita lihat ada di atas kotak wayang ini untuk berikutnya dimainkan dalam play selanjutnya ya, adegan-adegan selanjutnya. Jadi ini di kiri ini ada peniti. Lalu ini saya mencoba eksplorasi angle memotret Mas Nanang dari atas. Dari atas ini saya pegangan railing waktu Mas Nanang pentas di mall. Nah ini angle-angle seperti ini yang saya iseng suka cari gitu, dimana kalau saya lihat apa untuk wayang kulit sendiri kan orang kalau saya ajak motret wayang kulit bilangnya ah bosen kayak gitu-gitu aja gitu. Nah saya berusaha menjawab apa komentar dari teman-teman saya yang saya ajak motret itu gitu. Loh, ini motret wayang bisa dari mana-mana, bisa lucu-lucu juga loh gitu. Nah ini salah satu angle pemotretan saya waktu motret Mas Nanang, yaitu dari atas. Ini bukan dari satu drone, pakai drone ya, nggak mungkin.
Tantangan memotret wayang yeah. Seperti ini ya.
Lalu, nah ini Ki Dwi Mas Doer ini. Ini saya memotret beliau dari lubang, bukan lubang sebenarnya. Ini saya mencari sisi-sisi, berusaha belusuk. Belusuk kalau bahasa Inggrisnya apa ya, Mas Rizal? Belusuk gitu. Jadi di panggung wayang itu kan ada di depannya dalang itu ada penutup dari kain-kain gitu. Nah ini saya coba masuk ke dalam kain itu, mundurin piping, sedikit.
Piping.
mencoba mencari celah-celah di apa dari panggung sisi sebelah belakang. Bagaimana supaya saya bisa masuk ke dalam lubang ini dan memotret dalang dari sisi ini. Karena ini saya udah pengen lama nih memotret kayak gini. Cuman kalau Pak Mantep saya potret dengan cara kayak gini, kalau kaget kan saya bisa disadu. Sadu itu kena tendangan sedikit. Nah ini karena dalangnya ya, masih teman-teman juga anak-anak muda, jadi saya berani ini memotret. Kan nggak mungkin lah Mas Dwi kaget. Nah ini kita masuk. Ini juga jalur untuk kopi ya Mas Nanang ya?
Iya.
Jalur untuk kopi dalang ya?
Iya.
Terkopi. Cuman kok rapat sekali ya Mas ya? Waktu saya mencoba masuk ke di posisi yang pemotretan yang saat yang difoto ini. Oke, selanjutnya eksplorasi saya. Nah ini dari layarnya apa panggung wayang itu ada. Oh, seperti jahitan-jahitan itu di situ ada lubangnya. Nah, ini saya coba melakukan framing di sini. Saya coba ini manjat sih, manjat petinya di belakang panggung itu. Manjat peti minta dipegangin lah sama orang-orang di situ. Minta tolong dipegangin biar enggak jatuh. Nah, kalau jatuh kan malu ya. Jadi di sini saya coba pakai lensa yang rada agak wide ini 24 kalau nggak salah 24 mm ini supaya bisa dapat wayangnya, bisa dapat dalangnya juga itu dari dalam celah, dari memotret dari celah-celah layar yang wayang. Lalu kita masuk ke pendukung pentas, ini juga menarik untuk kita eksplorasi dari segi-segi yang bisa bermacam-macam. Di sini pengrawitnya Pak Mantap waktu itu nih, beliau yang di kiri ini pengendangnya tunanetra. Cuman semangat beliau luar biasa. Enggak ngantuk-ngantuk ini, semangat terus dan kendangannya presisi banget, bagus banget. Nah, ini kalau sebelah kanan ini pengrawitnya beliau. Nah, lalu ini bintang tamu. Biasanya kalau di pertunjukan wayang itu ada bintang tamunya. Ini yang sebelah kanan Pak Mantep. Kalau yang kiri pentasnya Pak Anom. bintang tamu itu biasanya muncul sekitar jam 12, goro-goro itu jam 12, jam 1. Juga satu hal-hal yang menarik juga untuk dipotret. Nah, berikutnya ini Sinden Warenggana. Nah, di sini saya mau cerita sedikit. Kalau yang tengah ini Mbak Agi Agnes Servozu. Beliau berasal dari Hungaria karena ketertarikan beliau terhadap pertunjukan wayang kulit itu sendiri, beliau memutuskan untuk melanjutkan kuliah di Indonesia dan berprofesi sebagai sinden atau warenggana sampai sekarang. Nah, ini di kiri, ini Hiromi Kano, sinden asal Jepang. Ini juga kenal dekat sama saya. Kalau ada berita-berita di koran Jepang ingin meliput beliau, biasanya beliau suka ngubungin, Mbak Hiromi Kano suka ngubungin saya minta di-share foto. Nah, kalau sebelah kanannya Mbak Pujiani Triplex, saat ini sedang ngambil S2 ini beliau ini. Ini dalang-dalangnya apa mantep. Mungkin Mbak Pujiani udah selesai kayaknya ya, S2-nya. Ini merupakan orang-orang hebat yang menjadi sindennya Pak Mantep dan dalang-dalang lain juga. Lalu, nah ini di sini saya bercerita tentang komunikasi. Di LFH sebelumnya, waktu saya sama Mbak Nungki Kusuma Stuti, Dr. Nungki Kusuma Stuti pernah beliau di situ berbicara tentang komunikasi seorang fotografer. Fotografer tuh ya jangan diem aja gitu. Komunikasi lah gitu kan. Supaya apa bisa membina hubungan baik juga dengan artisnya supaya motretnya juga enak gitu. Nah, di sini saya tunjukkan waktu Mbak Agnes Servozu dan ya karena sudah lama ketemu, sering ketemu di pemotretannya Pak Mantep, ya jadi teman akhirnya. Malah pernah satu kali saya lagi motret, tiba-tiba dipanggil, disuruh dekat, apa Mbak, gitu. Tahu-tahu dibawain rengginang dari Solo. You know rengginang, Mr. Kostas? Rengginang.
Yes, I do.
Rice cracker.
Nah, inilah pengalaman saya sama menjadi sahabatnya Mbak Agi. Saya manggilnya Mbak Agi ya. Bermula dari pemotretan wayang itu sendiri saya waktu dari Pak Mantep. Lalu, nah ini Mbak Agi tadi selesai, tadi pas dandan, nah ini selesai dandannya seperti ini. Jadi sambil di situ saya juga eksplorasi apa yang menarik untuk difoto. Nah ini saya mencoba akhirnya memotret buku teks lagunya yang dipakai Mbak Agi. Ini kebetulan ada beberapa buku ya yang beliau pegang di kanan itu sampulnya biru, kalau yang ini yang saya foto merah. Nah ini kira-kira seperti ini notasi-notasi lagunya. Ya, ini menurut saya menarik ya karena inilah yang dibawa oleh para sinden atau para warenggana dalam pementasan wayang. Nah, berikutnya ini gantian Mbak Agi, Mbak Agnes Servozu yang motret saya gantian ini. Pas lagi motret. Ya, jadi kita bisa lihat, oh, dari sudut pandang warenggana atau sinden itu ini loh. Ngelihat kita itu kayak gini. Gitu. Kalau tadi kan kita ngelihat sinden. Nah, ini sinden lihat kita begini. Oke, lalu ini sampai ke waktu saat saya awal-awal bertemu dengan Mas Kostas, waktu beliau mengontak saya dan berbicara ingin dikenalkan dengan dalang-dalang kesenian wayang tradisi yang ada di Jakarta. Nah ini kita di sebelah kanan itu kita mendatangi Bu Lansi. Mas Kostas melakukan pemotretan profil di depan rumah beliau. Nah, ini kalau kiri, yang di sebelah kiri ini kita lanjut ke rumahnya Mas ini Gamblang Carito, Ki Gamblang Carito. Seperti itu. Nah, mungkin demikianlah kisah singkat saya, cerita singkat tentang pemotretan atau eksplorasi angle dalam pemotretan wayang kulit yang saya lakukan dari tahun 2014 sampai sekarang. Semoga bisa menjadikan semangat juga bagi teman-teman fotografer yang terutama yang ada di daerah-daerah yang dimana di situ ada banyak kesenian wayang kulit. Ayo kita coba eksplorasi angle-angle yang lain, sudut-sudut yang lain yang menarik supaya wayang orang ini juga secara visual bisa kita hadirkan dengan menarik, dengan cara yang sudut pandang yang berbeda, agar kalau orang di mancanegara melihat wayang kulit, mereka bisa tertarik untuk menonton pertunjukan juga apabila mereka sedang visit ke Indonesia, sedang berlibur ke Indonesia. Demikian, Mas Rizal, Mas Reski, pemaparan dari saya. Kurang lebihnya mohon maaf apabila ada salah-salah kata dan ada kekurangan-kekurangan. Saya ucapkan terima kasih untuk teman-teman moderator dan para hadirin sekalian. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Cukup menarik. Mantap. Ya, paparan dari Mas Faisal. Sebetulnya sebelum lebih jauh, hari ini kan biasanya Mas Dodi yang mengiring acara Eleva, karena Mas Dodi ada halangan, jadi kita berdua, saya dengan Mas Rizal yang mengiring acara, karena ada bintang tamu khusus dari Sydney, Mr. Konstantin Korsovatis, lancar deh.
Kostas, Mas Kostas.
Mas, alias Mas Kostas. Nah, dan ada juga Ki Dalang Nanang HP, Mas Nanang HP. Nah, Mas Nanang juga bisa menambahkan mengenai apa yang sudah dibawakan oleh Mas Faisal tadi. Mas Nanang ini sebetulnya mewakili dalang muda ya, ya milenial mungkin ya. Mas Nanang adalah lulusan dari ISI Surakarta yang sudah menelurkan berbagai macam karya juga, melahirkan wayang urban dan dongeng Mi Fa Sol yang format pertunjukan wayangnya sebagai wayang alternatif untuk menarik penonton kaum milenial atau penonton muda. Yang kita ketahui kesenian wayang kulit ini biasanya kalangan milenial agak kurang bisa ini ya, bisa menerima karena ya, dipikir membosankan atau mungkin aduh pertunjukannya pakemnya begitu-begitu terus, bosen lah. Nah, mungkin Mas Nanang bisa sedikit menambahkan juga. Monggo Mas Nanang.
Ya. Terima kasih Mas Rizky. Mat malam teman-teman, mat malam warga hukum dan Mas Rizal, malam, Mas Kosta, Guti Sending, Mas Kosta, Mas Faisal, Pak Kim, dan juga tentu beberapa banyak sahabat yang berkumpul, mungkin baru kenal, salam kenal untuk semua. Saya akan langsung saja supaya ini menjadi ya efektif. Saya berusaha untuk menyesuaikan diri dengan keterbatasan saya dalam pemahaman teknis soal fotografi. Tapi kurang lebih saya akan berangkat dari pemahaman ya mungkin kacamata dalang untuk masalah fotografi. Nah, saya pikir pertunjukan wayang semalam itu substansinya itu ada di cerita sesungguhnya, ada di kisah. Jadi cuman kan hari ini wayang itu ada problem soal media ungkap. Jadi bahasa pedalangan atau bahasa yang digunakan dalam tradisi ya, hari ini itu mengacu pada sastra Jawa Mataram. Sementara bahasa itu sendiri tidak digunakan lagi di kehidupan masyarakat sehari-hari. Ini problem. Jadi problemnya bukan di isinya. Kenapa saya berani bilang begitu? Saya paham bahasa itu, saya tahu isinya. Isinya itu nggak ada problem sama sekali, dia timeless. Dia menggambarkan sesuatu sangat detail, sangat indah. Tapi kebetulan dinarasikan dalam bahasa yang tidak dipahami oleh masyarakat hari ini, sebagian besar masyarakat hari ini, terutama yang muda-muda. Kira-kira begitu, berangkatnya itu dari situ sebenarnya. Nah, kalau ngomong masalah visualnya, ya kalau ya wayang itu medianya audiovisual. Memang ada teks-teks verbal yang diucapkan, dinarasikan, dikisahkan oleh dalang, baik berupa narasi maupun apa dialog-dialog wayang itu. Tapi di luar itu, selain itu kan juga bahasa visual, maksudnya ada gambar. Meskipun ini gambar bergerak. Yang kalau diambil satu frame ya, dan kebetulan yang ngambil teman fotografer, berarti kan jadi foto. Ini jadi momen yang terabadikan. Saya membayangkan, wayangan itu mulai jam 9, selesai jam 4, ada 7 jam. Terus, ya misalnya saya ambil frame-nya video aja, misalnya 30 frame per detik yang nggak maju-maju amat, maksudnya yang sekarang standar gitu. 30 frame per detik berarti berapa itu? 1 jam 30 kali 60 180 108.000 per jam gitu. 108.000 foto per jam misalnya. Ini ngomong ngayal saja. Betapa banyak momen yang lewat ketika itu pertunjukan itu menjadi pertunjukan live yang dia setiap frame-nya lewat-lewat saja. Nah, fotografi punya potensi sangat besar di sana untuk nangkep momen-momen itu, lalu membuatnya menjadi abadi. Tapi sebelum itu semua, saya termasuk yang percaya bahwa semua itu asalnya dari pandangan pertama dulu, niatan pertama. Saya yakin banyak di antara kita sepakat wayang itu sedang ada problem, sedang apalagi di kacamata teman-teman muda, ini wayang ini kuno, lambat, kadaluarsa, ini konsumsi orang-orang tua, dan seterusnya. Nah, apapun, sehingga wayang ini nebulous, dia remang-remang, dia samar. Nah, kita yang pengen apa ya, revitalisasi, pengen membangkitkan wayang lagi ini dari bidang apapun, termasuk mungkin fotografi ya. Saya berpikir sama-sama remang-remang, milih yang mana ini, dusk or dawn. Jadi kita milih yang remang-remangnya senja, para remang-remangnya fajar. Kalau milih remang-remangnya senja, apapun yang kita lakukan ini masuknya masuk museum aja. Dia ada di dalam ruangan, tapi kalau kita milihnya fajar, kita nyambut pagi. Berarti ini dinamis. Berarti kita akan bawa wayang masuk kepada zamannya. Tapi ya pikiran saya itu. Nah, saya termasuk yang milih remang-remangnya wayang hari ini itu remang-remangnya fajar, bukan senja. Saya milih di sana. Karena toh wayang itu selalu begitu. Wayang zaman Kediri berbeda dengan misalnya zaman Majapahit, ke Mataram berbeda lagi, ke Mataram baru, ke Solo juga beda lagi, dan seterusnya, termasuk teksnya. Sehingga substansi ceritanya masih tetap, tapi bahasa ungkapnya itu ternyata iya, misalnya dia berkembang, menyesuaikan dengan zamannya. Gitu. Sebenarnya dari situ. Nah, saya membayangkan, bahkan di dunia wayang sendiri, tampilan yang ada di layar itu trigger. Mas Rizky, Pak Kim, Mas Kosta, mohon izin, itu trigger. Sehingga semua yang terjadi itu sebenarnya ada di kepala penonton. Baik itu pengalaman baru yang terbangkit karena melihat, baik rasa suasana maupun mungkin komposisi, bayangan, ya semua pergerakan yang terjadi di sana, maupun trigger itu, suatu situasi itu membangkitkan kenangan lamanya penonton. Asal sudah begitu, buat saya itu remang-remangnya yang fajar tadi, yang penuh dengan optimisme itu. Nah, Mas Faisal pernah tanya ke saya, Mas, berharap apa kepada teman-teman fotografi sebenarnya? Pewayangan itu. Yuh, kalau pewayangan tidak berani Mas aku, tapi kalau dalam pikiranku sendiri, supaya tahu jawabnya tidak terlalu besar, ini pikiran subjektifku, Mas. Aku bilang, saya bilang begini ke Mas Faisal waktu itu. Momen yang kemudian itu menjadi sebuah foto, momen yang tertangkap oleh fotografer itu, dalam pikiran saya, itu akan bisa menjadi trigger bagi yang melihat foto itu untuk membangkitkan ketertarikan ketertarikan tentu banyak hal ya di wayang itu. Seni rupanya ada, macam-macam lah pokoknya. Tadi sudah dijelaskan oleh Mas Faisal panjang lebar. Banyak hal yang sesungguhnya terkait, tapi karena media ungkapnya tidak diakrabi oleh khalayak, maka tidak dikenali lagi. Semacam itu sebenarnya. Kalau audio saja bisa membangkit, maksudnya audio tok saja, itu membangkitkan imaji sekuat itu, saya kira visual juga begitu, termasuk fotografi. Maka eksplorasi terhadap hal-hal yang terjadi di panggung, ekspresi dalang, kaki dalang ngeprak misalnya, nggak ngerti. Itu pasti tes ya, pasti pengalaman nangkep momen, dan seterusnya. Saya kira seputar itu. Jadi sama-sama, kalau saya sebagai dalang semalam itu berkisah, saya kira fotografi kok ya juga begitu. Asalkan fotonya ini bercerita, saya kira ya mau motret apapun itu sebuah apa pertolongan, sebuah bantuan, adalah sebuah peran yang besar untuk sesuatu yang menjadi objek pemotretan itu. Jadi membahasakan objek itu dalam bahasa gambar, tapi ya berkisah. Berkisah punya, dia jadi jendela, jadi trigger, jadi daya tarik, jadi magnet untuk orang, jadi nyari tahu lagi. Oh ini kok gini ya, ini kok gini. Kurang lebih semacam itu, Mas. Ini dengan pemahaman saya yang amat terbatas untuk wilayah fotografi. Jadi mungkin ini sangat umum, tapi ya setidaknya ini mungkin mudah-mudahan ini mewakili kalau seandainya ada pertanyaan-pertanyaan seputar pertunjukan wayang dari teman-teman fotografer. Kalau soal tata krama yang di itu sifatnya sebenarnya umum, tidak kemudian wayang sakral dalam arti ini apa ada magicnya apa enggak, bukan itu sih. Saya kira itu tata krama yang umum pada saat kita berada di seputar orang-orang yang sedang duduk dalam arti duduk di lantai, karena pengerapi duduk, dalang juga duduk. Kalau di tengah-tengah mereka kita berdiri, nggak usah wayang, di tempat yang bukan wayang pun kan yang begitu itu kurang pantas, sebenarnya kurang pas. Ya, sebenarnya ya, begitu saja. Iya, jadi sebenarnya sesimpel itu sih, sesimpel itu. Kurang lebih begitu sih. Jadi ya saya terima kasih sekali. Siap. Ini nambah apa ya? Nambah sahabat lagi, terus semakin yakin lagi. Yang mencintai wayang itu banyak, pasukannya banyak. Terus apa? Saya bisa bukan menjamin ya, tapi karena saya ada di ruang itu saya berani menyampaikan bahwa yang ada di dalam wayang itu, di kisah-kisah wayang itu, hal-hal yang amat bernilai. Nah, demikian saya bertemu dengan sahabat-sahabat yang berusaha menyampaikan itu lewat disiplin masing-masing ini. Ya, ini tambah saudara berarti. Kira-kira sebenarnya seperti itu. Demikian Mas Rizky, nanti kalau ada tambahan lagi yang seputar ini bisa dilanjut.
Thank you.
Cukup untuk sementara. Mungkin saya nyimak.
Mas Rizal juga bisa langsung menyambung.
Ya, oh iya. Iya. Itu tadi kita dengar langsung ya dari dalangnya sendiri. Jadi sudut pandang dalang ini. Halo, suara saya dengar ya?
Iya.
Oke. Jadi sudut pandang dalang. Memang kalau saya ini gara-gara ini saya jadi baca-baca lagi sejarahnya wayang itu gimana. Ya nyuwun sewu ya. Nyuwun sewu. Jadi saya baca-baca sejarah. Saya malu sama Mas Kostas gitu loh. Jadi jadi saya jadi baca-baca. Saya kaget loh, wayang ini udah 1500 tahun yang lalu loh. Itu sudah ada gitu loh. Artinya dari abad ke abad, dari tahun ke tahun, dari abad ke abad ini pasti ada berkembang sesuai dengan perkembangan zaman, perkembangan budaya, mestinya begitu. Ya. Artinya ya kalau misalkan ya saya nggak bisa ngomong sih bagaimana seharusnya wayang sekarang ya.
Iya.
Bisa ngomong seperti apa karena itu sangat sangat luas sekali pengertiannya. Mungkin ada kalanya kita perlu menyimak ya sudut pandang yang diambil dari orang yang tidak atau
nggak tahu di Australia. Is there any puppet show in Australia?
Yeah, we do have puppet shows, but and shadow puppets, of course.
Mm-hmm.
Also, like wayang golek, of course.
Oh, wayang golek. No, but I mean that.
No traditional
native Australian puppet show.
Yes, we have. Look, we have local stories and okay. local characters, of course. Yeah.
Nah,
I like that very much too. Yeah, I like all kinds of puppetry. Yeah, so it's not just wayang kulit.
Jadi ini Mas Kostas ini saya langsung tanya kepada beliau, tapi ini saya harus jelaskan ini. Jadi ini kan sudah mulai ada 29 partisipan yang mulai kemarin waiting for Mas Kostas. Jadi artisnya kan sekarang Mas Kostas ini. Jadi saya harus mulai dari awal ini dulu. Mulai dari awal, mulai perkenalkan diri Mas Kostas. Jadi saya mau share screen ya. Share screen yang sudah disiapin. Kelihatan semua? Kelihatan?
Kelihatan, Mas.
Oke. Okay. Nah, jadi seperti tadi mulai dari awal bahwa hari ini kita kedatangan tamu, ya. Kedatangan tamu namanya Konstantin Korsovitis. Atau kalau teman-teman di Indonesia atau di Jawa itu karena namanya unik banget, agak susah untuk disebutin, jadi diambil gampangnya. Jadi diambil lidahnya orang Jawa, diambil Mas Kostas gitu, manggilnya begitu. Jadi Mas Kostas seperti yang kita lihat sekarang ini adalah seorang fotografer lepas Australia. Jadi ini protapnya supaya Mas Kostasnya ini juga enggak bingung. Karena saya tulis di sini paparannya bahasa Indonesia, jadi saya harus nulis pas pakai bahasa tetangga ini apa bacanya pakai bahasa tetangga. Jadi this is about Konstantin Korsovitis as an Australian freelance photographer. Konstantin has a master degree in documentary photography from Sydney University and a diploma of photography from TAFE NSW.
New South Wales, ya.
Yeah, New South Wales. Tepatnya di sana. He has regularly exhibited his works both within Australia and internationally. Jadi, dia teratur memamerkan karyanya baik di Australia maupun di Australia. He is an active participant in Sydney music scene and a regular contributor to the Australian Free Press. He has worked in some Australia largest festivals. And during his overseas travels, he developed a strong interest in traditional theater, which led into a long-term project of documenting shadow puppetry throughout Southeast Asia. Jadi ini yang lagi digandrungi sama Mas Kostas ini. Is that right?
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Okay. Sebelumnya kita simak dulu ya. Simak dulu penampilan sedikit tentang karya Mas Kostas ini. Oke, si lorok.
Suman. Sepisan maneh. Ojo kumampang, ojo jagake doke si lorok. Yo nek ngedok, ku nek mung nelek. Nah, kerget-kergeti. Ya wis, ya kemanyan. Dunia ini, ayo. Siap di. Dandano sebagus sing cakrak ojo nganti kecuali pun kakan yang sakup akan karapake dalasan mbak yung yang kadamu sakloron pangkatan kadi kajakso soro pasonto tak par kaget diri jen perlu hormat yo kalau satu lagi lagi duit cing di balonok kadamu kajakso dan soro pasonto berantem oleh kerusak.
Thank you for that, Master Rizal.
Yeah, and, that's Jadi itu garis besar.
Yeah, greetings to everybody and thank you for joining us. I just wanted to thank everybody for joining us and thank you for the invitation to speak today to my friend Mas Faisal and of course. Mas Nanang Hape, of course, nice to see you again. And of course, Mas Rizal and Mas Dodi for moderating tonight's workshop. Thank you. I'll quickly just talk about the project outline. And I'll just tell you that while I was traveling overseas in Southeast Asia and I traveled to many countries like Thailand and Indonesia and Malaysia. I was struck by how each country had its own distinct culture and also many common cultural and religious and linguistic characteristics. The one thing though that I noticed that that was in common with each country was wayang kulit. So I was very interested by that. And what I decided basically to do is I wanted to do a documentary project. And the idea is that I wanted to photograph the puppet masters in their homes, yeah? Not in performance, but the idea was to find out who the man was behind the artist, behind the mask, yeah? You find sometimes that the dalang can be like actors or movie stars, yeah? So I wanted to strip this mask and I wanted to see them as everyday men, yeah? As farmers, as grandparents, as ordinary men, basically. And I'll tell you a little bit about my research, which I did both in Australia and Indonesia. So what I did before I came to Indonesia is I realized that the common characteristic in amongst the shadow traditions is the use of the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. So what I did was I read the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. That was the easiest way for me to learn what the stories was about, yeah? Learn about all the characters and what happens basically in the story, yeah?
Okay.
So I also read a short history of Indonesia. So so I can understand a little bit more about politics, about culture, about food, about you know, history, about what happened in the area, yeah. And also I spoke to my friends in Unima, and they told me basically which person I need to contact when I was in Indonesia, so they can help me with my project. So when I came to Indonesia, the easiest way for me to find out about Wayang was to visit ISI. So I visit ISI in Yogyakarta and ISI in Solo.
Solo.
So I went to the Pedalangan department. And I speak with some of the lecturers, and they say, okay, who is the best Dalang, and which is a very good performer, and why, and who's the most famous Dalang in Indonesia. So that was very easy. And from there, I slowly contact one Dalang, and then another Dalang, and another Dalang. But I also contact many foreigners who do their research in Indonesia. So like people like Matthew Cohen and Kitsi Emerson, and also many academics throughout Indonesia. So I can get many, many information. And once I have the information, then I can go and photograph the Dalang.
Okay. So it means that you spend a lot of time to study before, yeah.
Of course. I had to do
it. As detailed as possible.
Well, it's not just getting one name and then just going to visit this person, or you have to get some background too, yeah?
What makes puppet or wayang, it's so interesting to you? What's the point of that?
Well, it's easy, but maybe we can look at some of the black and white photos first.
Okay.
And I will explain exactly what you mean about that.
Okay, this is Life in Shadows by Konstantin Korsofidis.
Basically, this is Dalang Cheng Blong, who is the most famous Dalang in Bali. And as you can see behind him, he has his shrine to the Wayang gods, and he every day he gives some offering to them, so he will be successful and he will be lucky. I would have to say that Dalang Cheng Blong is probably one of the most spiritual Dalang I've ever met, yeah? And also he's also one of the most funniest Dalang I've ever met, yeah? So very nice man, and also he's also very serious, yeah? So he made me very welcome into his home, and as you can see, he's relaxed and happy, and very happy to sort of welcome me to his place in Ganyar. So maybe we can have a look at the next photo. Again, another Balinese Dalang. His name is Wayang Wijaya, and this is a photo that I took in 2015 in Ubud. And he's a very celebrated Dalang in Bali. He's very famous too. And he do many, many performances overseas. And he's quite rich. He speaks very well English. And he also gave me a lot of information about Balinese Dalang. He's very knowledgeable. And let me just say something so our audiences can understand this a little bit better, is that every time that I visit Ai Dalang, I also interview them.
Mm-hmm.
So basically there's an interview process and also photo process. And also I take some video as well. So as you can see, he has a, he's very relaxed, and this is in his home in Ubud. So maybe we can have a look at the next one.
And this one is the famous one.
And this is the famous Dalang, you know, and the very, very first time I come to Indonesia was in 1999, yeah?
1999.
And the first night I come to Indonesia, that the first day I come to Indonesia, that first evening, I see Pak Manteb perform, yeah? So you can imagine how lucky I was, yeah? And yeah. I was amazed, yeah? It was, I cannot believe this Dalang, yeah? Excellent technique, great rhythm, great fight scenes. And I was very lucky to go to visit him in his home, in Karanganyar in 2015, and to photograph him. And I found that this man was difficult to relax, yeah? So he's always
serious. Performing.
He's always got the mask of the actor together, yeah?
Yeah.
So yeah, for him to relax, it was difficult, but I think that I got some really nice photos of him, and he's probably one of my favorite Dalang in Indonesia, yeah? Fantastic performer.
He's very strong character.
Yes, you can see it in his face, yeah? Yeah. There's something about him, and it's all in the eyes, yeah?
Yeah.
Fantastic performance. I cannot, if I can compare him to, and I told my friends here in Australia, and they laugh, and I says, don't laugh, yeah? When you see a great movie star in Hollywood, then I can put Pak Manteb in the same category. He is a master. Great storyteller, great voice, great rhythm. So when we talk about great Hollywood performers, if Pak Manteb was born in Hollywood, he would be a huge star.
He deserves to get Oscar.
I would agree with that. Let's have a look at another one. Okay, this is Dalang Ki Muki. He's a Dalang from Cirebon in central North Java. Mm-hmm. And this is at his house. And when I spoke to Ki Muki, he spoke to me about philosophy of wayang. And he also spoke to me about morality. And it got me thinking, you know, about Dalang and what he does, and what is the purpose of wayang. And he said many, many interesting things to me. And I'm very glad to have met Dalang Imuki. And he also told me that he was one of President Sukarno's favorite Dalangs in the 60s.
In the 60s.
Yes, he performed for Bung Karno many times, yeah? So he had some stories to talk about him. And of course, another favorite Dalang, and this is Dalang Ki Purbo from Solo. And I photographed him in his home a few times, yeah? He was always very happy to have me in his house. And he's also a wonderful storyteller and a great performer too. Yeah, he had a great voice, and also he's very handsome. Yeah, he looks like a movie star. Huh? I think that also one of my favorite dalang in Indonesia. I think that he's a great performer. I see him perform many times, and every time I see him, he's very funny and I think a great storyteller. It's all right, there's no problems. We go back one slide.
Go back one slide. No.
Going too far.
Ah, keep here up.
Yeah, a lecturer at EC Surakarta, and another dalang that I met in his home in Solo. So as you can see, I want the dalang to be relaxed and, you know, to make them comfortable, yeah? That's the idea. He also has a great voice, and he's also a great carver of puppets. He makes many, many beautiful puppets, yes? Yeah? So... Yeah, I was very happy to meet him, and he also makes some puppets for me. So I was very happy to see him at work. Yeah, and he also had many interesting things to have to tell me about wayang, and also about teaching wayang to young Indonesian students.
Yeah, I think that's the important thing. It's not easy to teach wayang to.
No, it's not easy.
Now. Yeah, it's not easy.
It's not easy to teach, period. Yeah, I think that you have to like it, yeah. Whether you're teaching wayang or maybe you are teaching, you know, English or teaching anything. Yeah, you have to have a hunger. You want to.
Yeah.
Your students.
You have to hungry. You have to be hungry.
Look, when I was in school, I was lucky and unlucky. I was lucky. I have some really good students. Some really good teachers. But also, I was unlucky. I had teachers who don't care. You know, they don't want. They're not interested in teaching. Yeah? So, it is one of those professions. So another. Famous dalang and musician, and also a carver, and of course the creator of Wayang Kansib. Yeah, Ki Lajar Subroto. I visit in Yogyakarta in 2015, and probably one of the most beautiful smiles I see in dalang. He was also very generous with his time. And also very humble, yeah? I think one of my favorite photo shoots was with Pak Leja.
So wise, yeah.
Yeah, very beautiful. Beautiful smile. Another Balinese dalang is Dalang Wija. I photographed him in his home in Ganyar in 2016. He was a little bit more difficult to read. Yeah, while he smiled, there was a sadness behind him. Yeah, I could not understand what that was about, and I didn't want to push him. I think he was a little bit sick as well when I met him, so I try not to push him too hard. But it was beautiful to meet him. And also, he was a very spiritual man, yeah?
Ah.
You probably know this dalang. I photograph Mas Nanang in Jakarta in 2016. And I also see him perform in solo. And look, I enjoyed photographing him, and also we had a coffee together, and we spoke about wayang performance and also about wayang urban. Yeah, I'm interested to speak to the younger dalang and also to know what they're doing that is not traditional. Yeah. Also, I like this image very much. Yeah, it reminds me of a old Hollywood portrait. Yeah, maybe like a movie star from the 20s or 30s or something like this. Yeah, so yeah, very interesting.
Or maybe a rock star.
Yeah, a rock star too. But yeah. I think it reminds me of a silent era movie star from the 20s.
It seems he is the younger dalang that you have portrayed.
I think he's, I photographed some younger, more younger than him, yeah?
But, oh, I see.
Yeah, the youngest dalang I photographed was maybe 8 years old.
Oh.
Okay, so one of the ideas was also to photograph the craftsman and the sinden and everyone associated with wayang kulit. So this is Pak Sakyo. He is the number one craftsman in Yogyakarta. Also a teacher at EC, and also I forget the other name of the place that he teaches, but he also, he takes care of the puppets at the Sultan's Palace in in Jogja, yeah? He create many, many wayang puppets.
Wayang, call it, wayang puppets.
And he teaches many foreigners. He teaches young kids. He also, he's very generous with his time, yeah? So I visit him many times to photograph him and to video him, and also to learn about the crafting of wayang puppets. He also make some puppets for me to take back to Australia.
Oh, it's good for you.
Yeah, of course, of course. Okay, so this is...
this is young dalang also.
Yes. Yeah, he's a younger dalang, Kiseno Nugroho. He's very popular now in Jogja, yeah? And I photographed him a couple of times in his home in Yogyakarta. He's also, he's more intense and more silent, but also very generous with his time, yeah? So I enjoy photographing him, and he has a very strong face. And yeah, I like his performances. Yeah, he's is a very good dalang. And yeah, he's more mysterious in some way, but I like him very much.
So this okay, is
Wayang Suket. Wayang Suket, yeah.
Wayang Suket.
Made
grass from wayang grass, yeah? From grass.
And I hear this is something that you can teach children with. Also, I like the idea of making puppets from something different, yeah. So I photographed this at the Kekayon Museum.
I just read that Wayang Suket, a wayang made from grass, is the oldest wayang ever created. So yeah, the history came from this one, from this grass wayang.
Okay.
Wayang Beber.
Okay, well, the first time I came to Indonesia, which was in 1999, I also see a performance of Wayang Beber. So I must admit, I had no idea what this was, but it was very, very impressive, yeah? Really, really beautiful storytelling, and the Dalang who was doing the performance was fantastic. Okay, another Balinese Dalang, Dalang Natha. He is from Ubud. And as you can see from his smile, a very beautiful smile, and one of the oldest Dalang I photograph. I think he was maybe 85 years old. And also a really famous Balinese Dalang, yeah? This is again in his home in 2015. Okay, so I would imagine Mas Faisal remembers this day. Yeah. We got to photograph Dalang Ibu Sulansi in her home in Jakarta.
Jakarta.
She was a very funny lady, yeah? And also I see her perform. And a wonderful performance, yeah. And she made us very welcome in her home, and very, very nice lady. I have nothing but nice things to say about her. So thank you to Mas Faisal for taking me to meet her.
Dalang Ibu Lansi.
This is a Wayang Golek puppet of Dalang Kientus.
Kientus.
I go to his home in Tegal to photograph him, and he was very hospitable, very very generous, also very, very funny man, yeah?
Bupati Tegal.
So, this is in his home in Tegal. This is a blind puppet master. In Thailand. Yeah, this guy is probably the most famous puppet master in Thailand at the moment, and he's also blind, yeah? So very, very interesting, yeah, to see somebody do wayang kulit when they cannot see. I asked him how he can do this, and he told me that that God gave him one great gift. And I asked him what that was, and he said it was his imagination.
So I can imagine. I can imagine.
I can imagine. If I can imagine it, I can do it. Okay, another younger.
Young Dalang also. Is.
Yeah, younger Dalang from Solo. That's Ki Chayo Kuntadi. I visited him in his home in Solo, and I photographed him, and he was meditating on that evening. He was having a performance of Wayang Kulit. So he's a very young, intense guy, but also a very good performer, and also very generous with his time and with the explanations about what he's trying to do with Wayang.
What is this? Okay. This
is actually basically Kun Nakarin, who I photographed in Songkla in Thailand. And if you can see the photo, it's like a suitcase where he puts inside all his puppets.
So I
just open it, and it's made from bamboo. A traditional suitcase for when the Dalang take the puppet from his home to the performance. Okay, this is just an abstract.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, many beautiful. Black photos. I like the tiling effect here, the mosaic effect here, just putting different images together and make one big square image, yeah? It's one of my favorite things to do as a photographer.
I like this one.
Yeah, yeah, I like it too.
Kun Kruang Sang.
That is a dalang from South Thailand. And again, he's an older dalang and a famous dalang in South Thailand. I photographed him in his home in Nakhon Si Thammarat in 2015. And again, very humble man and a wonderful, wonderful performer.
So you traveled to many countries in Southeast Asia.
That's right.
You find many kind of puppetry. So did you find any similarity?
Of course, yeah.
In terms of maybe in terms of history or in terms of a story.
Well, that's the whole thing that binds everything together. Yeah, that yes, there's puppetry, shadow puppets in say China and yeah. Japan, but what I'm interested in is Southeast Asia, and the common factor Mas is they use the Ramayana and the Mahabharata
as the basic story.
That's it. That is the common thread.
Yeah.
Dia ada kesamaan cerita ya khususnya
ada kesamaan ya di
Ramayana
Asia.
Ya di Asia Tenggara ya.
Asia Tenggara.
Exactly. That is the influence of India in Southeast yeah. Asia. This is my friend and a Malaysian puppet master from Kelantan. His name is Pak Dain.
Pak Dain.
And he's a traditional puppet master, but he also do the famous now in Malaysia. He do the Star Wars wayang kulit.
Oh, Star Wars wayang
kulit. If I tell you, if you see Star Wars wayang kulit, it is amazing. If you are a Star Wars fan, then
so did he use the Star Wars story as the basic story of his show?
But if you look at the puppets, it's
yeah.
Darth Vader and Han Solo and
yeah. Princess Luke Skywalker.
Leia. Yes, all of them, but in wayang kulit format. That makes shadow.
Oh, that's interesting. Mm-hmm. That's interesting.
I will tomorrow, if you have a look in Facebook, I will post some photos
jadi,
of the Star Wars puppets.
Mas Nanang, ini yang baru Mas Nanang. Jadi, cerita Star Wars diangkat. Jadi nggak tahu nanti di kita ini akan menjadi seperti itu atau gimana ya untuk menciptakan faktor wow-nya ini yang biasa ditunggu oleh anak muda kan?
Ya kalau di kita karena akar tradisi itu sangat kuat Mas, jadi akan bermunculan seperti itu. Tapi cuma jadi tren. Ya dia wow
mungkin tren ya
untuk tren. Dia surut. Jadi ya mungkin perlu untuk letupan-letupan untuk
mungkin untuk trigger ya,
tapi ya, substansinya sebenarnya ya bagaimana penyikapan terhadap ya ini mainstreamnya ini dulu yang kulit ini kalau disikapi sebagai artefak ya udah habis kita gitu.
They are very beautiful to look at. I will tell you they are amazing to look at.
Okay.
Okay, another Malaysian dalang,
Malaysian Pak Sulti,
and I photograph him in his home in Kuala Terengganu, and this guy has a beautiful voice, and he also does voiceover for Malaysian cartoons. And this is probably the last photo.
The hands of dalang, or
yeah, this is the hands of all the dalang. And if you can recognize the hand of any of the dalang, Next time I'm in Indonesia, I will buy you a drink.
Wah, ini boleh juga ini.
If you can look and if you tell me if you can recognize the hands of Wan Dalang, I will buy you coffee or a drink.
Tantangan buat Mas Faisal ini.
The right on the top is Pak Anom Suroto.
No.
Top right?
Top right. No.
No, top right is from Malaysia. Top left is from Indonesia.
Oh, blessed Mas.
Aku aja yang ratiri kopi.
Yeah.
Top left is Pak Purbo Asmoro.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Your works is it's beautiful. It's more like majority you took a picture, then your style is like portraiture documentary.
That's the idea. I photograph many different things, but the idea is to photograph the Dalang away from the performance.
So you try to catch the correct character of the performers.
Exactly. I want to show the Dalang away from the performance.
I see.
Okay. So just quickly, so I don't want to bore everyone who's listening, just
okay.
Some of the project goals that I had is to foster basically relationships between all the countries involved and all the Dalang.
Okay.
To create an archive for future generations.
Mm-hmm.
To honor and promote the Shadow Theater.
Mm-hmm.
And also to increase public support for traditional arts.
Nah, ini Mas Kostas ini tujuannya mulia banget ini. Jadi dia memang pengin melestarikan benar-benar pengin melestarikan seni ini dengan cara jadi dia mendokumentasikan semuanya. Makanya gaya fotografinya juga dokumentari karena dia basicnya juga dokumentari. Jadi dia expert di situ ya. Expertise-nya memang di dokumentari. Jadi kita kelihatan banget di situ tadi.
Alright.
So that's a very very good goal.
Well, it is. Look, I have personal goals, but the main objective is to create knowledge and promote the Dalang. And also to give them respect.
Yeah.
And there's many, many other reasons, but those are the main reasons. Yeah, to promote wayang around the world. Yeah. Let me just quickly tell you why. I did
why this project? Why wayang?
Okay, so. It's probably one of the most frequent questions I've been asked over the years.
It says,
why do you like wayang? Why you want to do this? And
you are
not Indonesian and you cannot understand the language. And why you want to do this, you know? And okay, well, I have one good reason is that, and this is a personal reason, is that... when I was a very, very young boy, I went to Yunani.
Yeah, Greek.
And I see a performance of wayang kulit. Yeah. And I.
Do you mean Indonesian wayang kulit?
No. This is
Karagiosis.
From Karagiosis. Yes, that's right.
Oh, Karagiosis.
And I loved it. I loved it. And I'm thinking, okay, that's something that's very nice, huh? So when I travel back, when I come to Asia the first time and I see wayang kulit, immediately my brain says, okay, you know this, yeah? You like it. So you must watch it. So, and I was watching it and I'm thinking, this is something special, yeah? Just, I couldn't understand why it was special. But I could feel it, yeah? Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The energy was there And I thought to myself, you must find out more and more about this. So what I liked about the wayang and what I is the spirituality, yeah? The spirit of wayang, yeah?
It might be the way God to tell the message.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. Tell the message about kindness, about humanity.
It's education.
Education, yeah.
It's storytelling.
Yeah.
It's religion. It's propaganda.
Mm.
It's everything. But the main thing that I like most is the spirituality aspect, yeah? And let me explain that quickly. What I mean by that is, I like the ability of the dalang to make me dream. Yeah, do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I can close my eyes, and I can travel back in time. Yeah, I can enter the dream and visit the old Javanese kingdom. Yeah. I can feel the spirit and I can take the side, yeah? There's good and there's evil. And you must make the choice, yeah?
Yeah.
And I think that's what I like the most. Being able to put myself in this dream, yeah? And to also to heal my soul, yeah? To heal my heart, yeah?
That's amazing. That's amazing.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense for me. I myself is more spiritual people too, because you know, I'm already 50 now, so this is not curhat, but this is really the real thing that in my religion, that after you get 40, so you have to think about your God. You have to think about, are you evil or are you angel? So I can feel that.
Look, I learned a few things along the way. And what I learned is basically to be open in my heart and to approach my subjects with respect. And also with understanding, yeah?
Mm.
I was very worried because I don't speak Bahasa and I don't speak Javanese.
I said, it might be a language barrier, but there is no visual barrier.
No, there's no visual barrier.
Yeah, there's no visual barrier. It might be a language barrier, but there is no visual barrier.
I think that if the... When the dalang can see me, I am smiling and I'm listening and also have good eye contact. So maybe we cannot communicate, but we communicate by spirit, yeah? And I think that's the important thing, yeah?
Yeah.
I want people to be comfortable and also to understand that I'm there with positive energy, yeah? I'm not there to do anything bad, yeah?
Yeah.
I'm not there to take and take and take. I'm there to also give. Give from my spirit and give from my skill and give from my photo, yeah?
Amazing. So it's amazing. Okay, yeah. So the next... What I learned along the way, I think you already explained it. You just told that. Yeah.
Let's keep going. So
the future for wayang. This is the important thing for the younger people. So
yeah, look, I think the future for wayang is technology, of course. Also, I think Bahasa.
Bahasa.
Bahasa Indonesia is a good thing too. I spoke to many young Javanese people when they are at the performance, and I asked them, you know, what is happening. Mm-hmm. They cannot understand the performance. I asked them, why can you not understand what the Dalang is saying? And he's saying, this is old Javanese. I cannot speak this. I cannot understand this, yeah? So I speak to many, many Dalang, and they say, why don't you have more simple language? And everybody says the same thing. The language is a problem for Wayang, yeah? So maybe with technology, maybe with Bahasa,
yeah.
Maybe the younger generation are more interested. But also, I think that Wayang has to evolve, yeah? Has to embrace new stories,
yeah.
New ideas, and also maybe new music. And that's what I like about what Mas Nanang is doing, yeah? And what other Dalang are doing, which use different ideas, different instruments.
So do you consider Mas Nanang as a progressive Dalang right now?
He's traditional Dalang, but he's a progressive Dalang together.
Progressive Dalang also.
I think you need both. I think you cannot be just a progressive Dalang. You need to be traditional and progressive together, both.
Yeah. Okay.
So I think that's what the future is.
Yeah. So what is the future for Wayang? This is
some like advice to photographers.
Yeah, some advice for the photographers, because this is a community. Actually, majority in LFH is photographer. Me myself is I'm in the association, also same association with Mr. Faisal. So
look, if you want to do good documentary photography,
yeah,
I think it's important to understand and to honor the past, yeah. So I think that if you want to move forward as a artist or as a photographer, you need to understand the past, yeah. And I'm not talking about yesterday, I'm talking about 50 years ago and 100 years ago. And you know, you need to know
the history. The history.
So if you're going to India to photograph, then you need to know Indian history. Like I come to Indonesia, I need to know Indonesian history. I need to know what happened during the colony. I need to know what happened during the, you know, the Mataram kingdoms and before that, yeah? So as far as the photographers, I think that you need to be humble, and also if you want to tell somebody's story, it is important to say, to be honest and to do it as much justice to the people whose story that you're going to tell, yeah? So when I go to photograph a Dalang, many of that Dalang are very old, yeah? So I have to establish a connection first, yeah? And then we talk, and then we drink tea, and then maybe we smoke a cigarette. And then I ask for their permission to say, okay, it's okay if we take some photos now, if we do some interview. So be patient, yeah? And also be prepared. Do your research, have your equipment ready, so be prepared, and also to be prepared in your heart, yeah? And also, if things don't work out, then there's always tomorrow, yeah?
Yeah.
Don't stress out, don't be afraid. Many times I happen that maybe my photo assignment does not work, yeah? What can I do? I travel on a bus, I am sweaty, I am tired, and then the Dalang is sick, or the Dalang has a performance, and I cannot do it, yeah?
Yeah, I think we as a photographer, one thing that most important for us is the passionate. So the more passionate you are, you will get the more good picture.
That's it. You have to be patient.
You have to be patient.
And you have to wait for the right moment, yeah? You can't just rush and say, oh, okay. Anyway, I've been talking for a very long time, so I will finish and give you my epilogue. And what I try to do is basically just trying to analyze how art and culture and philosophy are rapidly changing, yeah? And also to try and to understand what is Wayang's principle of philosophy and belief, yeah? Because the Wayang has many, many different layers and many different meanings. And also to try to work out what is the future for traditional art and to remind people that local wisdom and knowledge should never be forgotten. Yeah. Don't forget your roots. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's okay to embrace all the new stuff, but it's useless if Wayang disappears, yeah? If there's no more Wayang, Indonesia is lost, yeah? Does that make sense?
That's very, very, very makes sense.
You can have all the modern things and you can have everything and you can have heavy metal and punk music, and I see many great heavy metal bands in Indonesia, yeah? Fantastic, and I embrace that. But you need Wayang to continue, yeah? It is very, very important. I realize that in the heart of every Javanese person is Wayang Kulit.
So, bagi
itu ya,
teman-teman, ya, bagi teman-teman yang pengen akses ke website-nya Mas Kostas ini bisa tengok di Instagram-nya di karma_image dan www.karmaimage.com.au.
That's right.
Ya, silakan tengok-tengok, dan Mas Kostas ini orangnya welcome banget. Saya tadi kaget juga ditelepon sama beliau. Saya sudah I told you before that I've been almost 15 years never talking with foreign people. So my English is very broken.
That's okay. I understand you. So I hope it wasn't too boring. And terima kasih.
No. Sama-sama.
For inviting me.
Sama-sama.
I hope there's some questions and maybe some people want to ask me something, or always, you know, feel welcome to, yeah, ask me some questions, yeah.
Sudah banyak pertanyaan nih, Mas. Kayaknya di kolom.
Oh, sudah banyak ya?
2000 pertanyaan kayaknya.
Wih, you have 2000 questions.
2000 questions.
2000 questions. So I will stop share. So we'll meet again, and oh, we still have 22 participants. That's amazing. So it means that your story is very interesting for us. So it's because this is very rare.
And if people are not participating tonight, and if they want to email me or want to message me in Instagram or in Facebook, and they have some questions, I can always answer tomorrow or the day after. I'm always happy to do so.
Yeah. So tonight is 9:55. What time is it in Sydney? Maybe
it is nearly 2 o'clock.
Almost 2 o'clock. You fell asleep now.
It's already Wednesday.
Not yet.
I'm sleepy, but I'm happy to answer some questions if there's some
okay.
questions.
There is 11, I think 11 question.
Okay.
11 question, but I will choose the maybe the most interesting.
Sure.
From oh, everybody congratulates to you. So I didn't see. Kira fokus wayang kulit, ternyata khusus dalang-dalang wayang kulit barangkali Pak Kim. Oke, okay. So Mr. Kim masih ada nggak ini? Pak Kim masih ada nggak? Oh, Pak Kim mungkin sudah ngantuk ya?
Iya, ada. Pak Imam yang ada.
Pak Imam.
Mas Ferry.
Do you know Mr. Ferry Ardianto, one of the professional photographer in Indonesia?
I do.
Uh-huh. He's here. You want to talk with him?
Yeah. How are you? Nice to talk to you.
Mas Ferry? Mana Mas Ferry? Mas Ferry, mana Mas Ferry? Oh, Mas Ferry, I think he already left. Yeah, maybe he's still asleep.
Pak Edial ada juga.
Oh, ada Pak Edial juga ini, Pak Edial. You know Mr. Edial? Edial Rusli?
Yes, I do as well.
Yeah, you want to talk to him?
Yeah, of course.
Nah, ini saya mau unmute Mas Edial nih. Assalamualaikum, Mas Edial. Silakan bersapa Ria sama Mas Kostas.
We meet you in ISI Yogyakarta, ya. Yeah? You.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
I am in photography. I look for you your exhibition in gallery ISI. Yes, the nice things. Your photograph, your documentary there. I look for you to ethnophotography. You take photographs detail. That's the and nice thing for your experience that. Thank you. See you.
Matur nuwun Mas Edial.
Di mana Mas?
Matur nuwun.
Nggih, sami-sami.
Kasih sudah mampir di
Alas Kostas. Mas Kostasnya kelihatan udah ngantuk ini
katanya. Di Katam City mana? Diisi kebetulan kami bantuin beliau untuk pameran di sana. Kalau nggak salah ya.
Yeah.
Kostas, you exhibition in RG Katamsi in ISI Yogyakarta? Halo?
Mr. Oh, Kostas? Ini mungkin
lewat mana nih? iPhone-nya.
iPhone. Oke. Okay. Okay. Unmute.
My iPad has crashed out. Yes, how are you, Mas?
How are you, Mas Kostas? Your exhibition in RG Katamsi last year?
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah, in September last year.
Yeah, with Erwandi. Yeah, it's Dr. Erwandi. And
yeah, of course.
Yeah. That's the nice thing, the nice exhibition in your ethnophotography there.
Thank you very much. Yeah, I remember you, yeah?
Yeah. See you. And thanks for the all.
No.
Arahnya kan ke Edno. Arahnya ke Edno.
Sehingga arahnya kalau ke Edno, ya.
Dia ke Edno, jadi dia memotret detail semuanya. Saya melihat fotonya, memotret profil-profil dalang. Kebetulan dia di pedalangan Jogja, terus kemudian ke fotografi, terus kemudian pameran di RG Katamsi. Nah, ini tantangan untuk Mas Faizal.
Ya, saya harus merambah ke etnofotografi ini. Sudah dapat ceramah.
Pernah ngobrol sama Mas Faizal. Oke, Mas, bagus Mas presentasinya. Sukses untuk Mas Faizal.
Sukses for you, aja terus.
Konstantin. See you again.
Yeah, of course you will.
COVID.
I will come back to EC hopefully next year.
Okay, I need you. Okay, I see you again in the last COVID, yeah.
Ask me, I will accompany you to Jogja.
I've been dying to go back to Indonesia, but with COVID it's very difficult, yeah?
Yeah. Okay, another, I try to find another questions. Ini
bonus
from
Bu Bonis.
Dodo Prasetya, Bu Bonis, Mas Kostas, you knew more dalangs, especially the famous one, than me. Stunning. With language barrier set, you get the philosophy of your traditional puppets and then transform it into your picks. Oh, this is appreciation from Bu Bonis.
Thank you. I think that if you look at the photos, you can see there's an energy between the photographer and the subject, yeah?
Yeah.
There's a empathy, yeah? You can empathy. See it, yeah? Everyone I show the photos, like here in Australia, they said, oh, how can you do this? How can you see this energy between the camera and the subject? I said, it's not between the camera and the subject. It's between photographer and subject. The camera cannot feel anything, yeah? It's me who feels it, yeah? And that energy goes from my heart into the camera.
So I also found a question from the young photographer.
Sure.
Maybe this is interesting. Do you from Dodo Prasetyo? Do you do it for free? How much did you get? Is it more into experience, portfolio, or what?
I got paid no money.
Nah, itu Mas Dodo.
I pay my own money.
Justru mengeluarkan duit sendiri.
Justru mengeluarkan duit sendiri.
I'm not making any money, yeah.
So this is not about money, yeah. This is not about money. Yeah.
I was making money before and I wanted to do something different, yeah.
Yeah.
So I said, what's in my heart? What do I like? What do I want to photograph? I said, okay, I like Indonesian food, I like Asian food, so I will go to Asia. So what else do I like in Asia? Wayang kulit. End of story. So
another one from, this is from Pekanbaru, Mr. Julian Sitompul. Mana Julian Sitompul? Masih ada nih enggak? Masih ada enggak? What is your next project you would like to expose about Indonesian culture besides wayang?
I think that my next project would be to go to India.
Oh, to India.
Photograph wayang kulit in India, yeah?
Oh.
But as far as... as far as Indonesia is that I think that I will photograph wayang kulit for many, many years to come, yeah? And what I would like to do as far as a different Indonesian project, I'm not sure. I like what the young generation in Indonesia are doing, yeah? And I think that is the future for Indonesia and maybe to bring some change too, both in culture and politics and the new face of Indonesia. So if I was to do a new project in Indonesia, maybe I would like to focus on young people. Yeah. And young maybe people. Maybe music, maybe things like hip hop or punk music, which I really like, or so the opposite of traditional arts. The other end,
okay.
Something modern, something to do with the younger generation.
Okay, so I got. Mr. Dodo Prasetya is already answer. I already guessed that you do it for self-satisfaction. Passion always the answer. Great job, sir. Makasih, Mas Dodo.
Makasih.
Yeah. Okay, mana lagi nih? Dodo Prasetyo.
Tanya-tanya tentang hal lain di Mas Faisal juga boleh.
Mas Faisal, ada ini? Atau yang lain?
Dari Pak Riyadi.
Ada Pak Riyadi. Mana Pak Riyadi?
Ada Pak Riyadi dari yang
Pak Riyadi Riyadi
Bandung.
Bandung. Jadi bagaimana tantangan wayang untuk bagaimana wayang mengadaptasi?
Oh, ini bukan teknologi. Pak Riyadi. Pak Riyadi ini dari Bandung, Mas Riyadi ini.
Iya, Mas Riyadi, Kang Riyadi.
Kok Kang Riyadi ya?
Bagaimana wayang mengadaptasi teknologi 4.0 untuk lebih menarik sebuah cerita? Mm-hmm. Dalam fotografi biasanya menggunakan lensa ukuran berapa untuk stage fotografi wayang? Nah, ini
mungkin.
Okay. Siapa nih, Mas?
What's the challenge doing a photographing wayang in terms of and the newer technology like industrial 4.0? You got what I mean? So, and how to adapt the technology of 4.0 to make it more interesting to tell a story?
Okay, so to adapt technology, then I think it's up to the dalang. Yeah, I think to make it to use technology. But as a photographer, I can use the best equipment that I can find. Also, I like to use both digital and analog technology. I like to do both.
So in this questions, he also asking about what lens that they use for photographing wayang that you usually use?
I always use a 50 millimeter lens.
Okay.
Always. Because this is the traditional photojournalism lens, yeah?
Yeah.
A 50 mil lens is exactly what your eye sees, yeah?
Yeah.
What
exactly
your eye sees?
What the eye sees.
Is the 50 mil lens, yeah? So as far as, because sometimes it's not easy to get close to the dalang, so I have to use the zoom lens, yeah?
Okay.
So I can photograph from the distance, like a 200 or 300 millimeter, and I can get very close to the dalang, yeah? So the details are important, yeah? But of course, there's so many things happening, so you can always use a 24 mil as well, yeah? For a wide angle, yeah.
From Mr. Sentot Harsono, Champursari. Do you know Champursari music?
I do.
You do?
Yeah.
From our former Mr. Didi Kempot. Almarhum. Campursari music in wayang kulit seems like can make can get interest from many people. Is there any other way to make wayang kulit like Champursari interest?
It's an interesting thing. How do you make traditional arts interesting for the younger generation? Yeah.
Yeah.
How do you make it interesting? I think that there's certain aspects of wayang kulit that some dalang do that I don't like.
Mm.
And let me explain that is there's some segments where you have the clone,
okay,
and have a comedy,
mm-hmm,
and you have the dancing, and I don't like that. I think that's not very interesting. I think,
okay,
I think new stories, technology, new music, stories that young people can relate to, yeah? Something that's a little bit more personal,
mm-hmm,
maybe a little bit more political.
Yeah.
Something that speaks to them about why their life is the way it is, yeah? Mm. How they can relate what they have to go through every day to what they see on the screen.
Okay.
Traditional stories are good, but make up some new stories for the younger people, yeah?
Just like that Mr. Nanang says, that Mas Nanang says that sometimes we need some trigger, but after you got to pull the trigger for younger people, just to make it interesting. But you have to go back to the history again.
You need to have both.
Yeah.
You need to have, that's what I was saying before, traditional and modern together.
And modern together. Oh, okay. I think that's all. We've done all the questions.
Okay.
So tonight is 10:12. 10:12 Indonesian time. So it must be 2:00, almost.
2:12 in Australia.
2:12 Australia.
And it's already Wednesday, yeah?
It's already Wednesday.
It is already Wednesday.
Yeah. We are here, okay. Still Tuesday.
That's okay. I'm happy to talk about it. And
okay.
Thank you for inviting me, of course.
I'm glad to hear that, Kostas. So at the end of the event, we would like to take a picture, like a selfie together. So bagi teman-teman yang masih atau mungkin tiduran atau belum bangun, nggak apa-apa. Tapi kalau yang bangun tapi menyembunyikan ini, silahkan memperlihatkan wajahnya masing-masing. Kita mau selfie bareng, foto bareng. Pak Joni mana nih? Mas Pradipta Pamungkas, Mas Sentot, Mas Rudi Sofian. Pak Sentot. Pak Joni.
Jangan lupa besok ada acara LFL lagi juga.
Oh iya, besok ada acara apa nih?
Ijen Geopark menuju UNESCO Global Geopark.
Wow. Tomorrow we have another event about Ijen Geopark. If you'd like to join, we will send you an invitation.
Yeah, please send me the invite.
Okay. Ayo kita foto bareng. Wah, ada Lai Brujul. Yuk kita gini semua, yuk.
You said before, Mas, that you had many, many questions. So if the people want to message me directly,
yeah,
in Instagram or via Facebook, I can answer their questions maybe tomorrow or the next day. It's no problem for me.
Oke, okay, bagi teman-teman yang masih pengen tanya-tanya sama Mas Kostas, silakan kontak di Instagram, bisa message di Instagram langsung untuk tanya-tanya.
DM langsung ya.
Iya, DM langsung. Instagramnya tadi karma underscore image ya, jangan lupa. Karma underscore image. Oke, okay, kita foto bareng. 1, 2, 3. Sekali lagi, yang lain mana nih? Oke, okay, 1, 2, 3. Ini cuma satu halaman, tinggal 17-nya bawa dua yang untuk semua. Oke, okay. Terima kasih buat teman-teman semua yang masih sampai sekarang masih mantengin monitor di acara Kang Riyadi, Pak Sentot, Pak Sabto, Mas Dodo Prasetyo, Mas Faisal, Mas Nanang, Mas Rismi, Mbak Gusta Nadiuska, Bu Bonis, matur nuwun. Terima kasih untuk semuanya. Selamat malam. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Sampai jumpa di pertemuan berikutnya. Mas Kostas, see you. See you again.
Have a good night.
Have a good night. Okay.
Thank you. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih. Sama-sama.
Bangun. Keras. Keras.